Hi there, this is Greg. I'm working on a new assemblage project that I want to kind of finish up later today. I'm using some of my favorite cabinet photos, the old photos that are done on these especially hard cardboard backings. I've got several of these, but the one I want to use today in my project is a fairly small one. It's a lady. It's just a lady's portrait, and I've got a little a piece of hardware around one of her eyes here. I've got some little blue blocks on the back because I want this photo to actually float inside my assemblage box that I'm going to be working on today. So my idea is fairly simple. The assemblage box that I'm using, this is the only thing that isn't recycled on my project. Well, it is kind of a recycled box actually. It came with a kind of a pressed board backing, but this is fairly flimsy and I needed something that was a little harder than this, so I cut my own piece of wood. And the second part of the project was that I wanted to line everything with some old vintage newspaper, so that's exactly what I did. I've got some old vintage newspapers that are really kind of yellowed with age. I've got a stack of these. I mean, the supply isn't unlimited. I am kind of running kind of short on this, but I lined the bottom of the box with the vintage paper. And in lining it, I do use my Yes Paste. There's a lot of controversy among collage and assemblage artists about Yes Paste. Some people really love it, and some people don't like it at all. I really, really like it because I don't get any bubbles or anything, and it just seems to last forever. I also lined the inside of my assemblage box with newspaper also. So obviously going to fit together something like this when I get done, and I'm going to begin to lay my pieces down. I've got the old vintage lady. I've got some smaller blocks that I have also lined or covered with my vintage newspaper. Smaller blocks, by the way, are just plain old wooden blocks. I've cut small strips of paper and I've just literally just kind of wrapped each little square, covered the square with Yes Paste, wrapped each little square. And I did take the squares after the glue had dried a little bit. I took them to my, well, I took a sander and I just sanded down the edges. I have a little rotary sander, which made it a little easier, but sanded down the edges of each of these little blocks to kind of age them a little bit. And my idea is I'm going to just create a little construction here with all of these pieces of blocks, covered blocks, in a manner such as this. And just the other idea is I'm going to use a label from an old Ex-Lax can that I got at a flea market here in the Portland area quite some time ago. The Ex-Lax can itself I'm not going to use, but I took it to a copier because I really liked the aged look, aged and rusted look of this particular label. So taking the label to Kinko's, of course, I enlarged it a little bit, and I've got two labels that I'm going to use, and these are also going to float a little bit on my piece. Plus, I have you see on the container itself, there's a thing here that says free sample, 2 tablets. I've also enlarged that. On a couple of these pieces, I put a heavier cardboard backing on the back, because I need this to be not so flimsy, especially for the way that I'm going to use these inside the box. So when I get this set up, let's see, how should I best show this? I've got a block here that's not going to be seen at all, and I'm going to float the chocolated laxative piece over her head in this manner. And I'm going to choose another of these two blocks that I've glued together down here at the bottom. And I'm going to set the free sample down here at the bottom. And these wooden blocks are going to be placed on the side, something like this. And it will hopefully come together in this manner with the final Ex-Lax label kind of up here on top. Now, what I particularly like about doing assemblages in this manner is that I have all kinds of dimensional stuff going on here, and I really like stuff that floats. I refer to this stuff as floaters. So I've got layer upon layer of something happening here. And eventually, see if I can find my other little strips, I'm going to put a border around the edge. I just literally cut out some strips of my aged newspaper. I'm going to put a border around, this might be a little bit too big here. I'm going to put a border around each of these sides. Let's see if I can find my other one here. Border on this side over here. Yeah, this piece right here is a little bit too big. I got to cut that down a little bit. And I'm going to put a piece down here at the bottom. Let me work on this a minute and see if I can figure this out. Okay, yes, I did get this figured out. I just had to cut one of these strips a little bit shorter. All right, so I believe this is basically what's going to happen here. I may put one of these paper frame strips up here at the top also. I'm going to have to look this over a little bit, but I've got my final X-Lax paper that's floating on top of the glass up here. The chocolated laxative, it's hard to see, but it's floating underneath. And then finally the picture and the other blocks are way down at the bottom. Free sample is floating underneath the glass here. So when I'm doing an assemblage like this, I always look at my, I see that I have several canvases that I can work on. I've got, of course, my bottom substrate that I can work on. I've got things that I can float in the middle, and there's always a number of things that you can do on top of the glass. The last thing that I think I'm going to add, I'm still kind of playing with this idea. I've got some old cutouts from one of those old Sears catalogs from a long time ago, from the underwear ads, before they started using real models for their underwears. I think I'm going to put these two guys right here on the side of each of these edges, corners of this assemblage, and kind of glue them into place in this manner like this. I think this will do it. At this point, what I really need to do is get serious about gluing everything down, and then I'll kind of show you what's happened at that point, and then I'll photograph the final project.